The new data acquisition request provides an interface to initiate data acquisitions for new or existing events. The menu-based form facilitates the collection of remotely sensed data in the aftermath of a disaster, as well as coordinating imagery of the same region prior to an event. A new menu will now pop up for your information. Start by entering the event details. Select an HDDS event from the pop-down menu. The list contains all active events, as well as options for a new natural or man-made disaster. New events can be entered as an unsupported cyclone, debris, earthquake, explosion, fire, flood, hurricane, landslide, oil spill, other, storm, tornado, tropical storm, tsunami, typhoon, or volcano event. Use the calendar pop-down to select the acquisition start date. Continue on to the image requirements section. Select type of imagery from the pop-down. Only one type of imagery can be selected per data acquisition request. An additional request will need to be submitted for each data type. Select desired image resolution from the pop-down menu. The image resolution options are determined by type of imagery and are populated after type of imagery has been entered. Publicly viewable data acquisition requests will be displayed on the event information page so that other responders can view the status of the image request. The username and agency of the requester will not be visible to other users. Are archived pre-event imagery needed? The default for this field is no. Use the pop-down menu to select yes if the data acquired prior to the event is required. This field is specific to the type of imagery. The quantity of pre-event data depends on the availability of existing data for the area of interest. Is repetitive imaging required? This field allows for multiple data acquisitions. Select the frequency of requested data acquisition from the pop-down. Your options are no, single collection, daily, weekly, biweekly, or monthly. Duration of acquisition is required. Select the acquisition end date from the pop-down calendar. Users also have the opportunity to input additional information about the event or data request. Next, define your area of interest in the spatial requirements section using the Google Map interface. The tools to do this are the same as described in the event search portion of the video. A coverage map for the area of interest will automatically populate for active events. You may specify a different geographic location. A smaller area can be selected within the coverage map to focus on a specific area, or an area outside the coverage map can be selected to expand the area of interest. Use the Google interface tools to zoom into your area of interest to better define the area. Next, click on the Submit Request form. A status bar appears to indicate that the request was successfully submitted and is awaiting approval. An automated email is sent to confirm the request and to provide a link to the data acquisition request details. After leaving the Collection Management Tool site, the request can be edited using the link in the email. Data acquisition requests can only be edited while in pending status. The data acquisition request can be shared with another emergency responder using the email data acquisition request information link. Only one email address can be entered per transaction. The data acquisition request may be edited prior to approval. If additional imagery types are needed for the event, a copy of the data acquisition request can be used as a template to create additional data requests. The user will be able to track the status of the request and receive active notifications from the Collection Management tool regarding any changes in the status of the request. The Collection Management tool administrator reviews and approves pending requests, making basic modifications if necessary. For each new or impending data acquisition request, approved requests are converted to an active event and shown as a data acquisition request on the collection management tool. As imagery becomes available, the data will be posted on the hazards data distribution system. HDDS hosts data files, browse imagery, metadata, and footprints in support of the emergency event. Notifications of new image availability is sent automatically to the requester. Lesson 7D provides an overview of using HDDS to discover and download imagery. When the request appears to be satisfied, the user will receive an email from the collection management tool to review the event collections. Upon satisfactory completion of the request, the event will migrate to the collection management tool archive. If the requirements have changed, the request may be extended or modified. You should now know how to register for access to the collection management tool through the AROS registration system, how to navigate around the collection management tool interface, and how to submit a data acquisition request.